Hello, hello, good day everyone. Welcome back to this exciting best of three. This is game two of Wings Gaming versus VGJ. My name is Hades and this is the Manila Masters Chinese Qualifiers brought to you by Beyond the Summit. Alright, so we had a really intense game one. That was some really sick stuff. I mean, of course, you know, I want to be nice and say somewhat questionable Echo Slam, but hey, you missed it, man. They heard it. They went for it. It was bait, man. FY God, it was all part of his master plan, which that's why we're not at his level. But alright, Team VGJ opening up strong. They will go with the Centaur Warlock. Wings Gaming taking up the Coddle for themselves. And there you can see Monkey King instant first ban. Not even a surprise now. That hero is just ridiculously strong. In the first 5 minutes, you can accomplish so much. And of course, of course, shout out to you guys in Twitch who are all tuning in. Hope you guys are enjoying the cast so far. I understand some of you are a bit sad that no one is here to give you dating advice like Cyclops, but here's a piece of advice for you guys. You want to go on a date, bring someone to go watch Beauty and the Beast movie with you. Spot on. That's all I can say. But yeah, anyways, Wings Gaming for a second pick. We'll see what they decide to go for. VGJ even taking out the Crystal Maiden, which is that hard pause 5. You start to notice as well that the Chinese teams, they just take out Magnus, they're really afraid of it. And they're afraid of the Crystal Maiden, but woo! Radiant, I'm not even sure what to call this new hero. I mean, technically OG when S4 plays Brewmaster, but... Alright, Wings Gaming, they take it up for themselves. This will be interesting to see how they want to play this hero. Should be a Faith Bian hero. What else do they go for? Well... Okay, they take out the Naga Siren, I'm glad. I mean, of course, you guys are... Don't deny it. When you guys saw the ban, you guys were definitely relieved. 5 seconds remaining. Alright, so... Third ban from Wings Gaming. Something to deal with that Warlock. I mean, you have to love Drunken Haze. Nothing like a bit of alcohol to make you make all the wrong decisions. And of course, let's see, what else would they decide to ban? I mean, it's really strange to see, or rather interesting to see how Wings Gaming like to ban out these heroes which seem unorthodox. But their bans, in the end, after some serious reflection, it actually makes sense. So, okay. What's the third ban here for Wings Gaming? But okay, yeah, I mean, VGJ back then, it was quite surprising to see RTK having a bit of Western influence. According to Mr. Jack, hello, KBBQ. Yep, he was the one who tweeted saying that RTK, he likes to watch Western games, so that's where the influence of the Abaddon offing kind of came out. Yeah, which makes sense. You know, he's one of the few Chinese personalities which well-liked by the Western community. I mean, you can't say the same about Singapore, that part I'm not too sure. But they know who he is. Right, so Wings Gaming, they will take out the Slark. I mean, if you don't know, if you're in doubt, just ban Slark. It's just one of the super annoying heroes, which you don't, you know, in any of your pubs, you just hate to play against this hero. I mean, I'm not sure whether you can say nerf him, but it's not like he has this 100% win rate or some ridiculous win rate. He's not OP. Alright, so Invoker taken out by VGJ. I don't think you see Blink playing that often on the Invoker, do you? I mean, yeah, they play the occasional Invoker, but nothing to like the miracle where you go, wow, kind of thing, do you? And Wings Gaming, let's see, took out the Juggernaut. Alright, that's a pretty safe pick as well. I wouldn't say it's like very exceptional, but it's a safe pick. Jug with the healing ward, able to siege without worry from the high ground. Have yet to see a Tinker, that might actually come into play.
10 seconds.
Right, so as we enter the second phase of the draft, just introductions for myself again. I'm Hades, all the way from Singapore. Hope you guys in chat doing all good, nice and dandy. VGJ now have a minute left. What will they go for? Centaur Warlock. Oh wait, okay, yeah, now that I think about it, it's surprising we haven't seen an Earth Spirit like pick or ban today. Even from the previous series between CDC and LGD, no one really placed any emphasis on Earth Spirit at all. I mean, considering that RTK actually plays Dark Seer, he's a good Darkseer, decent Darkseer. You know, you put RTK and Darkseer and you go in with like either Fenrir or F1 of Spirit. That's something which the Chinese teams really like to fall back on once in a while. It popped up a lot during like the Kiev Chinese Major qualifiers. Night Stalker. Right, but Team VGJ go with the counter pick. It will be the Night Stalker. Not even surprised there. Counter to the Keeper of the Light. The map pack. Alright, so third pick. Let's see, Wings Gaming. What else do you... Are you going to throw any new heroes at us? Are you going to set the new meta? I mean, hell, we're talking about Wings Gaming, the team which actually ran the jungling Nature's Prophet, I believe, and the support Nature's Prophet TP into mech. That was them, right? I'm not remembering this wrong. Yeah. But running out of bonus time as well. Both these teams taking a really long time to think about their draft. So Wings Gaming, they want to decide how to play against the Night Stalker. Going for the Storm Spirit. Radiant team pick. Chakra, Storm Spirit, great interaction. Alright, that's pretty decent. It's also one of those heroes who can zip to the backline, try and kill the Warlock off. But if you don't have enough damage, he gets a good Chaotic Offering, bang into the team. Can be a disaster. So you have two big ults to worry about, like the Primal Split and the Chaotic Offering. VGJ... 5 seconds remaining. We'll see. I mean, it's already going to be a Night Stalker. And one thing, you know, if FY God wants it, you just give it to him. Alright, they go back for the Ember, so the freeze Ember. I mean, unless it gets to the situation where, you know, you have the right-click Ember, it doesn't seem likely. I think they nerfed, like, what, the Veil, this level 10 talent from 12% to 10%, and... he still deals a ton of damage, like, that power spike is just too good to give away. And Oracle coming out... Alright, now that's a really scary hero to play with, it's like play against as well. You know, False Promise can just lead you into this false sense of security. What if Huskar came out? What do you guys think? I mean, do you think Huskar... I don't know, it feels very suspicious.
5 seconds remaining. Wings Gaming's turn to ban.
Alright, so taking out the Huskar, yeah, VGJ, they sense that coming. It only makes sense. Alright, so Wings, I don't know, I feel Ursa, I don't know why, I feel like Ursa is going to come out. Purely because the Fury Swipe's damage could actually destroy an Ember Spirit if you get the Purge. Like, think about it, you know, you're the Fortune Zen into the Ember Spirit, I believe you can purge off the Flame Guard, and stops him in his tracks for a tiny bit, but if he's out of Remnants, you get a good Ursa coming in, bang, 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 he swipes you up. Nice and toasty. They go for the Drow.
Radiant team pick.
Not sure how to feel about that, but actually it will be Wings Gaming, which means they actually want to take these quicker towers, but and if Ember has a bad lane, you know, he can't really accomplish too much for a bit, that's where they'll be forced to split, you know, take a more passive approach, lose objectives, they can't really contest it. But Draw Ranger, the silence as well is something which could be pretty good. Like, if you get a quick Fortune Zen, that right click damage and the silence could actually be enough to destroy the Ember. So, it's pretty good. It's pretty decent. Alright, so Weaver pick coming out. Weaver carry. Yeah, I guess with the lack of reliable stuns on the side of Wings Gaming, Weaver seems like a really good pick, especially for aggressive. And... it allows him to just go to the back line, you know, he can really do some serious damage with the Oracle, the Keeper of the Light. But of course, a good gust from Draw Ranger can very just as easily mess that up. So I'm just talking about, like, theoretically. Alright, so... this draft, I don't know how to feel about it, I would say the laning stage. Whether the Drow gets a lot out of it. 10 seconds remaining. They could even try running like the Centaur into a solo situation against the Brew, which allows Weaver, Nightstalker, and Warlock to play a more aggressive approach, like an aggressive lane. But Wings Gaming. I'm hoping, personally for you guys, I mean, even if VGJ does hit the better draft, in my opinion, I really like for this to go to game 3. Hype for me, guys. I mean, for me, it's like, it's just great to cast this. Alright, so let's enter our Street Fighter animation and introduction, and of course, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, bringing to you game 2. Wings Gaming versus VGJ. On the dice side for Wings, Faith Bian playing on your Brewmaster, Shadow gonna be playing on your Jaw Ranger, Blink on the Storm. You're gonna have Ice Ice playing on your Coddle, Maxine Y gonna be playing on the Oracle. For the Radiant side, Aggressive playing on your Carry Weaver, FY God gonna be playing on the Night Stalker, Freeze on the Ember Spirit, RTK on the Centaur Warrunner with Mr. Fenrir playing on the Warlock. Okay, so the Fenrir FY combo brings back the VG gaming days, man, with Ice Ice Ice. Oh, remember those days, never forget. Something about these two as a support duo, I'm actually surprised like teams never, like if you wanted to sign one of them, I'm surprised you never attempted to sign both because of the synergy there. Like sometimes you can perhaps sign over one piece of skill, but one thing you cannot sign or bring over is synergy. Alright. Okay, I'm not sure about you guys, but this, like, oh shit, see. Yeah, so I'm not, like, this Storm set sometimes gives me the impression like he could be a pedophile. I'm not sure.
Mommy said stay away from strange men with roses in their mouths.
Alright, so VGJ RTK gonna try and steal the rune, doesn't really get it. And they're actually running a dueling situation with Fenrir. Shadow and Maxine could be in trouble. Of course, Ice Ice coming to the mid, just giving a bit of help with the creep block. But okay, yeah, him and the Brewmaster together with the Chakra, it means he can have cast a Thunderclap pretty freely. More so than usual. So they run, it looks like they actually will run an aggro situation to try and contest the draw lane. And draw doesn't deal well against, like the one thing about her, theoretically, like she has great right click DPS, but her laning is really, really weak. So Blink and Freeze, both the Spirit Brothers, is gonna be, who's gonna win this one? The Fire Nation. This is, yeah. What do you call that duel thing again? I actually forgot. Oh, you're right, an Agni Kai. Who's gonna win? This is like that crazy sister drag, and this is, you know, Zuku. Alright, but anyway, Fenrir taking quite a bit of right click. Don't forget that Shadow does buff Oracle with that precision aura. So with that, the extra DPS, it does add up a tiny bit. Well, RTK is like the last person you really want to try on. Purging off Fenrir's Shadow Wood. Never knew you could do that. Alright, so Faith Bian, of course, with the Drunken Haze coming up in a bit, will be a bit more of an annoyance against Aggressive. Ice Ice, is he looking for a Courier Snipe? Could be just coming to try and harass that Ember Spirit just a tiny tad bit. And yeah, already you can see your Drow 4-2 not having the best of times with RTK 7-2. Things do not look good for Wings Gaming so far from this laning phase. Even Aggressive isn't farming that nicely. He's 5-0 compared to Faith Bian's 11-3. I mean, yep, with, of course, with the value pointing to the Drunken Brawler, with the miss rate and the crit, it's really, really good for Faith Bian, the way he lands. So, I guess this could be RTK's back, maybe? Alright, so to get the fortunes in, with a couple of rackets coming out to RTK, that return damage slowly chipping away. And Maxine's not too happy. He's running out of, actually, he's already run out of regen. Freeze with a casual regen rune. Very happy for that part. So Ice Ice is going to get a couple. Just one stack in. Going to be pretty big because together they can clear it with Faith Bian very nicely. The Thunderclap, always a strong nuke. Gets too close. He can die to that Thunderclap. Too many of those. Bugs don't do well in alcohol. Doesn't seem like Oracle's actually going to be stacking. Actually, he might after using the shrine. But RTK together with the Warlock in this lane, it seems like it's already been won for RTK. You know, having higher CS than the Drow in the safe lane. A lot of this is going to actually boil down to freeze. He tried for the chains, not really going to connect, and he's, yeah. Well, takes a blast to the face. And Ice Ice is just going to jungle. He's not actually going to give that away to the Brewmaster, and this is going to help him quite a fair bit, especially with building towards that Aghanim Scepter. Well, the first step would be the Tranquils. So FYI, level 3, we should be seeing our first rotation coming out at the 4-minute mark, once the first nighttime just, you know, settles in. Fenrir, of course, he wants to build towards that level 6 before we can see something happen. And bam, they get the fortunes in onto the Ember Spirit Flame Guard perched off. Yep, so there we go. You can see some of the potential synergy there already coming out, and if Maxine does always getting the purge off and getting rid of the Flame Guard, it allows Blink to go in for a quick and easier kill. RTK is actually playing more and more aggressive on Shadow. He's like, get out of here. And they get the rune, but bottom lane will be taken by aggressive. Probably doesn't want to give that away. Double damage. Mine. And of course, we're waiting for the Storm to hit that level 6, that one zippy level where by then he'll be so hard to kill. And because VGJ are just emphasizing on winning their silence. Of course, with the first nighttime, Ice Ice, he wandered into the wrong neighborhood. Oh, you know, that's why Mama always said don't walk too deep into the wrong parts of the woods at night. The Forbidden Forest, we shall call it. Top is missing. So RTK, level 3, with the double edge, when he gets a couple more levels up, he can start to jungle with the Tranquils, and Fenrir can actually just take over the lane then with a bit of, you know, extra EXP. So Oracle's just gonna try and heal up Shadow. Well, of course, that part at the beginning, you know, when Oracle first came up, people are getting heart attacks. Aggressive going for his bottle and rain drop. There we go. The haze is just going to be super constant pain in the ass. Like, aggressive can't really last hit with that. I believe, what's the miss rate again? 70%. That's still pretty big. Now, TP coming in. They want to go straight into FY with the drunken haze. They get the extra slow. Oracle with the fortune's end, but out of range, and they will just give up on that kill. They want to over pursue for it. Storm Spirit, of course, goes to the jungle. Ember Spirit, still level 5. Yeah, Storm definitely has the edge. 33-72-23-3 on the side of the Ember. RTK is going to be very happy with just clearing this camp, or this wave out. Getting some chip damage onto the tier 1, and Shadow is forced to take a very passive approach without his supports there, and they know it. Well, this time it looks like Wings Gaming definitely going to play this very, very cautiously. Don't want to miss out on this chance for the Minotaur Masters. Freeze with the Flame Guard. Actually, no, Blink. Oh, he's been one step ahead. He's going to get it. And without mana onto him, he actually might be able to run this off. But the Flame Guard will be perched off by Y. FY coming in, looking for the silence onto Blink. That little remnant, they actually might have enough with the silence. Actually, no, just kidding. And now, of course, they can draw the Drunken Haze. No, they will not. And actually, that won't be a kill. Aggressive was thinking about coming back in. Of course, they need the blast. Aggressive zipping all the way in to get the last hit. And bang! There we go. One nice kill for Blink. So, this is one of those times where your carry rotates in. Yeah, somewhere out there, some salty pub is going like, that's why carry doesn't leave the safe lane. And that's going to be the top tier 1. Nice and easy for VGJ. Alright, classic RTK. Already 5.5, almost under level 6. Needs the Stampede. He's actually really close to a Blink as well. He's going to skip the Hood of Defiance, but in this case, doesn't really seem like he would need it. I mean, 1400 gold, why not? You can just go straight for the Blink. But FYI, nighttime, one more minute before it's going to expire. Could think about going on to Shadow. Or Maxine would be the easier kill. Innocence. Going for the back. FY, he's going straight for the Drow Ranger. Fortune's end, he's going for the TP out. Is there any stun? Oh no, the silence was too good. Too long. Alright, so they want to try for something again, but Faith Bien is there. Freeze can't really touch him. Can't really kill him. Unless he like really messes up. 1-1, 7 minutes and a half in. This is more of that Chinese daughter, which I would... Unfortunately, I would... Yeah, I have to say that I'm actually more used to this, especially since I've casted quite a fair share of Chinese games. Alright, so blink, blink, blink. Treads on the way. Night Stalker, does he go for his Midas? Should be building into that at least, but after the Tranquils. RTK, yep, he pings up. He's on quick buy. He has to blink back coming up. Blink will get an Invis rune. Can you think about going here into aggressive? But I don't think they have enough damage. He has to raindrop and the one, plus the time lapse. And to kill him off in that tiny window timing, you would actually have to bring in the Drow or the Coddle. Right, to Coddle, Mr. Ice Ice, where are you going? No, no, no. Why am I getting lagged? No, what is happening? Draw Ranger taken to the jungle, doesn't really want to stay up there for... Alright, he's just about to complete his Rage Ban. He's very far behind, 24 and 5. And that aggro lane situation really paid off for VGJ. But hello, Blink at the back line, they have no detection there. This could be really, really scary, but now they want to go straight for the Oracle. And he should be dying here. They even pop the Stampede, the Remnant 4, they will kill Ice Ice next. So two quick and easy kills, and Blink just walks this off saying, sorry team, I don't want to take the risk. Anyways, 3 to run, VGJ look like they're in a pretty solid position to try and at least force this, not say force, but take this game too well. Seems a bit too early to tell, but we'll see, we'll see. Faith Bien, of course, wants to build into this Blink Dagger as well, but RTK is so much closer. He's just like two creeps away. Shadow's still trying to build into his Aquila. Fenrir wants his level 6. I mean, 9 minutes and a half in. It's good that they at least prioritize getting him the extra bit of EXP, so with the Chaotic Offering, they can actually take teamfights a bit more confidently. Storm, of course, going to build into his Bloodstone. No surprise there. Faith Bien, we haven't seen a Primal Split yet. Smack. I know, I mean, if you look at it from the angle, it actually looks like a bone. It doesn't look like a fan. I know it's supposed to be like a fan because it's off... Like, Brewmaster was kind of based off ancient mythology, like, at least for the design of his items and stuff. I mean, technically, you guys know, like, drunken boxing. It's actually a name for that. It's actually a martial art. But I don't really think many people practice that in the world right now. So, yeah, it actually looks like a femur or something. Well, he's like our daughter's version of Cubone. Anyways, we haven't seen a Storm rotate in with those big kills yet. He is high above net worth compared to the Ember. Now hold on! They take care of Maxine very easily, even using the Stampede to get out. Rick, sorry for missing that. But now the smoke, now using that Blink Dagger, they find a Coddle, that very big kill. Of course, with the Remnant forward, Freeze just cleans up shot, burning that old man to the ground. And unlike Gandalf, he's not coming back for a while, just 20 seconds. They want to keep on going RTK, they pop the Chaotic Offering, with the three heroes into the Storm with the Double Edge! And that should be the Storm Spirit going down as well, perfect Chaotic Offering coming out from Fenrir. Somewhere out there, this guy is going calculated, like a boss. And that will be the tier 1 taken out. Nice, clean, and precise. Woo-wee! He didn't even have mana for the Fatal Bonds, did he? I'm not sure. But a double kill for Fenrir, and he's going to be very happy about that. As it actually, I would say to a certain degree, accelerates his timing for the Midas timing if he wants to. Or he could just go back into Arcane Boots. And of course, with the Golem, he's just going to farm up the enemy jungle. It's not going to be up a tiny bit. You know, stuff up the Storm a tiny bit. Slow down his Bloodstone timing. Alright, so aggressive, gonna build his way into a Dragon Lance. RTK is now gonna build his way into a Vanguard. So, Crimson Guard on the way, that'd be pretty big going up against the Drow. You know, making sure of the damage reduction, and plus because he's already had such a bad start. Looking at that, you see bottom half of the net worth. Oracle is basically just... he's like a super creep right now. 643 net worth with only brown boots, can't even afford a TP. Well, now he can. Storm, they went straight for the illusion. Not the ideal target, but that's still a lot of fate. You know, for that 15 gold, you want it. Dire's middle tower is under So now, it looks like Wings Gaming will kind of group up, try and get some chip damage onto the tier 1 tower. But 8-1, VGJ are looking very strong, and I mean, there were a few doubts about them getting the last direct invite to Kiev, but in this case, I would say they're looking very, very sharp. Haven't really seen a primal split once again. 13 minutes in, still no ultimate use from Faith Bian. They haven't found the opening to do so. They were just demolished in this tiny corner. In fire and hell. Alright, so Freeze building his way to a blink dagger now. Skipping the BOTs actually. Never refuse gold given. And a poor Oracle. Poor Oracle. He just wants level 6 for the False Promise so that they can really go ham, take a fight more confidently. But VGJ, they read the lanes really well. The draft was just, it worked out so nicely in their favor. And you look at Night Stalker right now, he's already 25% on the way to that Aghanim Scepter. And by then, Caudle's Axe won't really matter. Stupendous! Yeah, you're gonna need Blink to pull off some really amazing Storm plays coming out. He needs to unleash that inner Sumail. Ember Spirit still farming top. They can slow things down a bit. Wait for the next ults, which coming up. And of course, Warlock already has Chaotic Offering and the completed Hand of Midas soon. So, you know, the recipe. This just means he's able to scale so much better. Even Aghanim's not out of the question. Aggressive, gonna try to take that tower down. One more click, we'll get it. And RTK aggressively behind the tier 1. Looks like no one wanted contest then. Wings Gaming, of course, they will take a more passive approach now. Even putting a very nice aggressive ward out here by FY. So, okay, VGJ right now, they will start to siege the tier 2. Still have a bit of that double damage. FY going forward. Do they have any follow up? Yep, they get the Hoof Stomp and the double edge. Goodbye. Oh, now going in, they want to pop the primal split, zipping all the way to the backline, but it's been popped. Where's the chaotic offering? Now gonna be landing right at it. Oh, with the remnants! The damage destroys Blink! And the false promise will be used defensively on himself. They're gonna try and kill out with Oracle. The primal split, not really paying off. And FY, actually, no, Fenrir gets the kill. And of course, with the, oh, the initiation at the backline, they kill off Shadow! And this could actually be a dieback from the Oracle. What's Oracle doing? Okay, they get the fortunes in, of course, with that nuke, with the purifying flames, to get one kill. But can he get the return to heal into Maxine? Fenrir is still quite low, but actually, no, he's gonna get healed up. He's just gonna TP back, trying for the heal nuke, not gonna pay off. So that's actually a really big ultimate. You lose 2-2, but hey, 2 calls went down for support and your enemy carry. Still a huge win for VGJ, 12-3, and it could have been much worse. Let's face it, it could have been much worse. Alright, so Freeze, 500 gold to his Blink Dagger. Aggressive with the Dragon Lance. I mean, considering that they're basically steamrolling, and RTK, even right now, he's playing crazy. 6.5k. The return of RTK, guys. True Sight from Kiev Major, maybe featuring RTK? Or maybe the next Major. Alright, so blink, almost into a Bloodstone. Ice Eyes, still very far from an Aghanim Scepter, but FY, you look at him, he's already halfway there. So that's a really good start, and that's without a Midas. So that says something, because all this gold from the towers is just crazy, and this is just a repeat of game 1. Like, now they're going to zip in, they want to try jumping him, but it looks like they will not be able to now zip into the back. Doesn't seem like they'll find it, and actually Freeze, demolishing off that Oracle. And with the Stampede, they will just disengage and decide to go back in. Now looking for Ice Eyes, the much easier kill for sure. FY, of course, with the Remnant forward, Bang trying to catch some of the Steering Chains, will catch onto Faith Bian. And Freeze gonna get Vortex, zip back in, and will die to the Storm Spirit. But the Caudal Blast dealing quite a fair bit of damage, aggressive, well, time lapse out. Doesn't want to get too low. RTK still all the way under the tier 2 to get the stomp. Looking for the double edge to get the kill here. Okay, Shadow Ward going to do quite a fair bit. And Faith Yen will go down. That heal from the Shadow Ward. RTK is still alive and they will not go for any more kills. Shadow just isn't able to do that much DPS. Like as a Drow, the situation in terms of map control should be the opposite for things to go well. That's when you know that's a really good Drow game. But in this case right now, VGJ are just all aboard the Jeremy Lin train. These guys are doing so well. And still Shadow opting to go for that Shadow Blade coming up soon. Alright, so... I mean, I could try for a quick reconnect. I'm just gonna try for a quick reconnect. Hopefully the lag will be gone. But this is just things where you connect to a Perfect World server. It's a hit or miss. You either get a really good, like, good ping, nothing happens, or you get the PowerPoint slides. Alright, so we're back. 15-4, VGJ looking still pretty dominant. No, I didn't miss anything. Yeah, didn't miss. Oh, okay, things look like they've kind of settled down for a while. Gonna try and get themselves a tier 1. The first tier 1 of the game, I believe?
Radiant's bottom tower is under
attack. No. Alright, yeah, this is just a really bad server. I think something went wrong. Maybe someone kicked the router in Perfect World or something. The Shanghai Major all over again. Oh, snap. But hold on, the outflank coming up from VGJ, they pop the nighttime, they're gonna go for the back, go straight for the Caudle, I believe. Actually no, they pop the Chaotic Offering, landing to 4 heroes with the chains and the Fader Bonds onto everybody. The Primal Spit's gonna come up, but Freeze gets the double. Oh, they're gonna actually kill off all these beautiful bears. Pandas. Yeah, they wanna wait for this, they're gonna wait for the Primal Spit to expire, it's gonna expire right now. Faith Bian all the way to the left. Journey to the rest, he's gonna travel the TP, I don't have anything, and of course the mini stun from the void will cancel his TP. You're not running anywhere, goodbye. Rest in pieces, and aggressive with a dominating streak. Double kill for two players on the side of VGJ. 4-0, perfect Chaotic Offering coming out once again with the Fatal Bonds. And RTK and friends look to be in great shape to try and take themselves to a 2-0 clean against the former TI champions. Alright, casual mana leak, try and stop him there, but it doesn't really matter. RTK will just walk it off. No, he's a centaur. And of course, FY, now he has the completed egg and Imceptor. These guys are looking extremely strong. 19-4 net worth wise. Alright, let's look at items, shall we? Let's look at items. So he actually went for the Diffusal Blade. I guess that's okay. Diffuse your teammates, if they're silenced, that could be pretty big. Well, it's just really good at picking off the supports in general. So, at the same time, you look at your Storm. Yeah, he has the Bloodstone, but it's still not enough to try. You know, like that crazy 1v6 Storm where you zip here, zip there, kill one target, go to the next kind of thing. And Shadow, because of how bad his laning was, he still hasn't come back. Now they actually look like they'll find themselves ice. I'm not sure what these guys did to him, but he's dead again. And FY, now they want to try and kill him, scope the turn with the Thunderclap, it will not be enough. And now it looks like the rest of VGJ are here for reinforcements. The Cavalry have come in, and Faith Bien will be brought down. Link needs to get out, trying for the TP, he's actually really low on mana. Will they try to chase for him? Aggressive, I'm pretty sure they see him, he's gonna zip all the way to the shrine. And there's just no more follow-up, but FY, hello! He sees Blink with the Void, the Slow, and the Silence, he's not running anywhere. Aggressive gets a couple more hits in. Of course, that mana gone, he's just gonna deny himself. Seppuku. You shall not see my shame. But aggressive, oh, they get the purge onto Maxi. Oracle, does he die down here? The silence, they're just gonna dive him under the tier 3. Oh! And aggressive. I don't think he understands this is a tier 2 there. Aggressive is like, I want kills. I see heroes, I go for the kills. Nice and easy kill. So, you know, 22-3, now 22-4 actually. We did it, team. We did it, Twitch. BOT is coming up from Freeze, and they will actually just go straight for the Roshan. RAT can tank this out nice and easy, no problem. And they have the Chaotic Offering, so they can take the tier 2, even force the high ground. While Drow still desperately trying to farm up that Shadow Blade. And I'm pretty sure they pinged them out. This ward scouted them out, leaving the base. Man, VGJ are just bloodthirsty right now. They're looking for kills. The easier alternative right now, like, I'm pretty sure. VGJ are feeling extremely confident right now. The eggs and the gem, they're just looking for wards. There's just no map vision and no map control at all for the side of Wings. like I said, you know, it boiled down to the laning phase where the ideal situation would be to take the early towers. This way you can take early, like, you know, get early map control so that the Night Stalker wouldn't be that efficient. But in this case, the tier 1s are still there, and it's only, I mean, exception at the bottom tier 1, but VGJ. And they will take themselves and Roshan, of course, with the Swarm. Negative armor, they take it nice and easy. With the Chaotic Offering still available, Wings are not in any position to try and contest this. Alright, so of course with the scan being used, nothing that Wings can do. Blink gonna try and farm towards that Orchid. Hasn't found any opportunities to try and increase those Bloodstone charges to a positive number again. He's really beneath the negative of the default. So you get one Diffusal Blade coming out from Aggressive. And what is his next item? It's gonna be the Hurricane Pike. No Deso on his part. Gotta love, like, Diffusal on a Weaver in general. It's just a really good item. Like, I know Singapore Miracle, he also likes to play Diffusal on the Weaver, especially against Morphling. Alright, so now they were gonna secure themselves the last outer tower before they will see Chigan with that Aegis, it seems. And even if your Wings, how do you initiate it? Usually you would expect that Faith Bien is the one who initiates into them. But now the Stampede, they're going straight to the backline. They want to kill Gandalf. Gandalf, no! And Ice, he goes down. They get the chains onto Oracle. Oracle goes down as well. Both supports down. VGJ, this diving pass and Aggressive is actually the first one to notice that, hey guys, there's actually a tier 2 still standing. Alright, so VGJ take themselves another tier 2 and they will start to break the high ground. But hold on, the sharing chains onto the Brewmaster with the silence as well and the void. Do they have enough damage for the Brewmaster? He doesn't want to be forced to use the Primal Spit. They get a stomp, double edge, clean up nice and easy, and actually it looks like he will be forced to buy back. Dire structures are fortified. Dire's middle tower. Zipping all the way in, gonna go straight for RTK. The buyback will come on up from Faith behind the silence. Landing onto the onto the Centaur. Does he die here? The Chaotic Offering into the backline. Two heroes. Fatal Bonds landing onto three. And big stuff, they're trying to try and kill Blink, but he's gonna zip to the fountain. So meanwhile, looking at all these bears, they're actually really, really low, looking for the double staring chains onto Oracle and keep up the light again. He's just gonna TP back. Can they kill RTK? No, they can't, he's just getting healed up. Oh, I don't think they're killing anyone here, and of course Freeze comes back into the party. Oracle did again for another 10 seconds, of course. But now, the silence coming up, landing to two heroes, we're gonna pop a stampede, go charging straight into Shadow. And I'm pretty sure Weaver doesn't even want to use time-lapse, he doesn't care. Now, buyback up from the Drow, zipping in from Blink. He's gonna try and kill the Night Stalker. Can he kill him? He's doing too much. He pops the Night Time with the silence up. Storm's gonna go down here. 25 seconds. Will he be forced to buyback? Can they hold the high ground? The double staring chains comes out. The Chaotic Offering Golem still doing quite a fair bit of damage as Freeze and Aggressive going ham. And looks like they will kill the Brewmaster off as well. And that was a buyback onto him. We have Keeper of the Light to follow him into the grave. Drow Ranger's not able to do anything. Buyback up from the Coddle. Storm Spirit does not want to buy back. Shadow's really low under the tier 4 towers. And of course, he used a ton of Diffusal charges for that. Freeze, he's nowhere near done. He's actually going to come back in just a fair bit. Aggressive, on the way out. Put the Sentry down, they pop the Dust. They want to try and go back for him. Of course, here comes Freeze. Hello, hello, where are you guys running? With the Remnant, he destroys both. And Storm Spirit, he's going ham. He finally kills off Aggressive, and it's a 1.5k kill. But now the Sharing Chains is going to be up there onto the Storm Spirit. Ember Spirit, he's going to try and burn his brother down. And of course, Zuko is not going to run away. Not able to save his teammate. So 33-7, and that was a 3-for-8 trade. They lost the Aegis as well, so you can make it 4-for-8 if you guys want to be technical about it. But 3 buybacks for us from the Brewmaster, the Drought, and the Coddle. They lose the Range Racks, they lose the Tier 3, but the big thing is the Melee Racks is still there. That's if you want to be optimistic. So, gotta look for the positives right now. Ember Spirit going into that Shiva's Guard. Makes things even harder for your Drow Ranger. When you get the Shiva's debuff up onto him, man, he's gonna hurt way less. So BKB coming up from the Drow doesn't have the privilege of trying to farm into an Aghanim's Maelstrom kind of thing. Blink also realizes that he needs the BKB. Once again, it's just these wall of golems really well placed from Fenrir. He's always at the back. There's no way to jump him in. If you do, you're just immediately KO'd. And Oracle and Coddle at this point, they're just super squishy. They're basically just food right now. Freeze, looking for the chains. They pop the stampede, they find the stomp. Oh, Storm Spirit. Do we get the double chains? No, they do not. But Maxine, of course, is going to be there. But with the golem back off cooldown now, that fight previously went on so long, and they want to mop up this melee barracks. Storm zipping all the way, doesn't even get the creep wave to be honest. The siege card is still there, and that's going to be a wasted zip TP. So FY and friends, they want to go straight for the melee barracks, zipping all the way in, doesn't really get the silence off though. And actually, no, Fabian now going to pop the primal split, and kind of misses it, the timing just a bit off, and FY looks like he should be the first one going down. Chaotic Offering coming in, okay, that's a bit weird, but Freeze getting the kill onto Shadow already, and now the Fortune Zen landing to 3 heroes, that's pretty big. Do they have any more follow-up? Freeze zipping all the way in to join his team. They want to try and fight here. No Drow. It's a big time. Using the False Promise onto him. But the Primal Split just expired. It's a wasted False Promise. And they will just decide to back off. Go straight for the Shrines instead. FY, Lotus Orb on the way. And Warlock going to build his way into an Aghanim Scepter. So Freeze. Shiva's Guard still, you know, still in the making. Ice Eyes with that Aghanim Scepter, but the problem is you always have the night time. Oh, they found Ice Eyes. They zip in all the way to the backline though. They want to go straight for the Weaver. They want to try and kill him off. Can they help him though? The Stomp is going to be there, and actually Aggressive almost dies. He time lapses out most of that damage, and looks like Storm Spirit will go down. And now of course with the Stampede coming out, looks like the Shrine Fenrir needs to get out. The double Searing Chains onto the Coddle and the Brewmaster with the Remnants in. Do they have enough damage? RTK looking for the stomp. They want to try and kill Ice Eyes. They actually will successfully kill him. Use Scepter tossing him up into the air. This should be Faith Dian going down one more time. They called it GG. They've been battered. They've been bruised. Their wings have been clipped. And VGJ are victorious 2-0, 38-7. Wings gain really, really unfortunate. Wings Gaming, that was just so hard for them. I've never seen an Oracle so poor. 1.4k, that has to be a new record or something. Someone has to check. I'll probably take a quick check after this. But yeah, Fenrir having a flawless game, 5-0-20. You can see that like his Chaotic Offerings were so on point, besides the one which was kind of lackluster, but otherwise he was super on point. Freeze just taking advantage of Ice and Y. Like I said, you know, it was just VGJ with the superior draft. The draw pick was questionable. But otherwise, guys, yeah, this is the end of the Manila Masters coverage for today, brought to you by Beyond the Summit. If you guys enjoyed the cards, of course, or if you know you want to tweet me some feedback, some constructive criticism, I'm open to it. Just let me know at Hades.tv on Facebook and Twitter. Of course, I hope to see you guys for more games tomorrow. I will be back tomorrow. So once again, have a good day, and I'll see you guys next time. Hades signing out.